Hi everyone, welcome to my lecture. I am Professor Dipanjan De. Today's lecture, the outcomes of this lecture, that is, the outcomes of this lecture, upon the completion of this session or lecture, the learner will be able to know the internetworking devices or internetworking tools. What is internetworking tools? Number two, the different types of internetworking tools. Then, in this lecture, students or learner will able to know the hub. The hub, the behavior of hub, and how does it work, hub. So this is very important in networking topic, networking, computer networking. So this is important for BCA, MCA, BTech, MSCIT, BSCIT, BSc Computer Science, NET and GATE exams, and others competitive exam throughout India also. Okay. So, internetworking device. What is internetworking device? Internetworking device means interconnect two or more network to form a single network. Interconnecting two or more network to form a single network is called internetworking. And the resulting network is called internetwork, and the resulting network is called internetwork. Interconnecting two or more devices to form a single network, that is known as internetworking, and the resulting network is known as internetwork. Now, what are the internetworking tools or devices? The following are the internetworking tools or devices. That means the following are the internetworking tools commonly used to interconnect two or more networks to form a single network. So that means first one is hub, repeaters, bridges, routers, gateway, and switches. These are the common internetworking tools used in internetworking. Okay, that means we have to use these tools. We can extend the length of the network. That means extend the network. So, in this lecture, I will explain now what is hub and the behavior of hub and how does hub work. Okay, so firstly, you see hub, it is a network device. First off point is it is a network device, because it is internetworking device, we can say network device. It is a network device, okay, or you can say it is a network tools. Number two, hub operates at physical layer of OSI model. Hub operates at physical layer of the OSI model, operates at physical layer of OSI model. First, hub works, operates, or hub works at physical layer of OSI model. This means that since physical layer, that means it is, we can say we have works at physical layer, then that means we can say it is completely hardware, not software. That means in half there is no software is there, so it is totally or completely a hardware, because it works on physical layer. As we know physical layer, there will be no software, only hardware is there. So no software in half, we can say. Okay. So no software works in half. So now next point, it is a multi-port repeater. Point number three, it is multi-port repeater. It is a multi-port repeaters. That means generally it is a multi-port repeater, means generally repeaters has only two ports. Every repeater has only two ports, but there are so many input devices, right? It may be four ports, eight ports, sixteen ports, etc. So we can say it is a multi-port repeater. So multi-port repeater, it is a multi-port repeater. That means a hub has a number of input lines that are joined electrically. You can say a hub has a number of input lines that are joined electrically. That means we can say it is a multi-port repeater. So now if I say what is the difference between hub and repeater, repeater has only two ports, but hub has so many ports, that is four ports, 16 ports, eight ports, four ports, etc. So next, point number four, hub provides forwarding facility. Hub provides forwarding facility. Forwarding means when any station want to send a data to another station, that means through hub, then the data first receive hub, then hub will forward that data to the destination address. Suppose this is a hub, just I am drawing HUB. This is hub, okay. This is suppose PC1, this is PC2, this is suppose PC3, this is suppose PC4. So these are the four, this is a four ports hub, or you can say this is a star topology. Hub, there is a topology, this is known as star topology, having a hub. So hub provides forwarding facility. That means suppose PC1 wants to send a data to PC3 through hub, that means hub will forward the data to PC3. So this is known as forwarding facility. Forward, just receive and then forward. Forwarding facility means just receive the data, then forward to the destination address. Forward the data. Receive and receiving and forwarding. Okay. So hub provides forwarding facility. I think you understand very nicely forwarding. Forwarding means suppose example I already given. Suppose once again I am telling another example. For forwarding, suppose PC1 wants to send data to PC3 through hub, so which is possible, that is just receive the data, then forward. Okay. Next is hub, next point, point number five, the signal is forward as it is. The signal is forward
as it is. As it is. As it is. Suppose the signal rate, suppose PC1 want to send the data to PC3, suppose signal rate is X. So signal rate is X, then the hub will forward the message to PC3 at the same X, signal rate is X. So that means the signal rate is forward as it is. That means when PC1 is sending a data at a rate, signal rate is X, then hub will forward the data message at the same signal rate, that is X. Okay. So I can write here, the signal is forward as it is. Okay. Clear now?
Next point. Next point, I am explaining next point. That is point number 6. Hub doesn't provide filtering. Hub doesn't provide filtering.
Number 6. Hub doesn't provide filtering. Hub doesn't provide filtering means
hub doesn't provide filtering. What do you mean by filtering? Filtering means suppose PC1 is sending data to PC3, the data will pass PC3 through hub, but simultaneously the data will pass PC2 and PC4 also. So that is, so no filtering capacity. That means in this point I am explaining,
hub doesn't provide filtering. That means suppose PC1 want to send the data to PC3, that means through hub, PC1 wants to send data through hub. So PC1 send data to PC3, it is possible. That is, but others know, that is PC2 and PC4, that means hub not only send this data to PC3, hub will send the data PC2 and PC4 also. That means there is no filtering capacity, that is there is no, in hub there is no software that only because PC1 wants to send data to PC3, that means only PC3 will understand and the data that PC1 sent. Every station will know the hub will send every station, that means every station will know the data. So that means there is no software in hub which having a filtering capacity. Okay,
understand? I think you understand very nicely. Or you can say there is no software in hub to filter the data. There is no software to filter the data in hub. There is no software. Filter means he wants send data to PC3 only. So what will I do? I want to send the data to any other station. Only that station will receive. But why other station? That is called filtering. That means other station automatically know. That means hub will send PC2, PC3 and PC4 also. That means when any station send data to other station, that means hub will not filter the data. There is no software in hub that he will send the data only the destination address. I think you understand clearly. So next point, so we can say from this point we can say another point. From this point we can say another point. Hub doesn't provide security. Hub doesn't provide, that means number 7. Hub does not provide security. Hub does not provide security. That means, suppose any station send data to other station, private message suppose they are sending.
So suppose PC2 is sending a private message to PC4. So PC1 will expect only PC4 will understand my private message because I am sending to PC4. So that facility is not in hub. So through hub, that means when the private message goes through hub, every station, hub will send every station. That means every station will know the private message. So we can say hub doesn't provide any security. So there is no security. Okay. So every station will understand the private message. Okay. And next point is in hub there is collision possible. collision possible. That means suppose PC1 sending data through hub, PC1, PC2, PC3, PC4, they are all sending data at a time. That means there is a collision in hub. Okay, so there is a collision in hub. When these four stations sending data at a time, that means the data will collide with each other. So that means maximum number of collision is equal to n for maximum number of collision possible is equal to n because n equal to number of devices connected through hub. Now what is n? N number of devices are connected through hub. Maximum number of collision is equal to n equal to number of devices connected to hub. Okay, so maximum number of collision is equal to n. Okay, so that means collision depends on the number of, we can say collision depends on number of stations. How many stations are there? So maximum number of collision is equal to n. For suppose there are four stations, how many collisions are possible? Only four collisions are possible. So this ends the hub, that is I already explained. So this sometimes question may be write the short note of hub, or you can say hub difference between hub and repeater also. In the next class, next lecture, I will explain repeater. In the next lecture, I will explain repeater. Okay. So today's lecture, that is hub. What is hub? Now you understand. It is a network device. Hub operates at physical layer of OSI model. It is a multi-port repeater. So hub provides forwarding facility. The signal is forward as it is. The hub doesn't provide filtering. Hub doesn't provide the security. In hub there is a collision possible. Maximum number of collision is equal to n. Maximum number of, these are the 9 points I have given. I think you understand very nicely. So in NEET and GATE exam, some typical type of question is coming. I think if you know these 9 points, then you can answer that type of question. So thank you very much. In my next video, it will be repeater. Till then, bye bye. Thank you.